So, hello, this is my grade 9 science applied class. So this is the activity that I did with them. I did do it in class, I did film it, however the video wasn't very clear. So I'll show parts and clips of that video in this one right now. So I got students to get into groups, and what they had to do was build a food web. So this is the example of the food web. So this was meant to show students how energy flows through the food web from producers to consumers, and how the flow of energy actually decreases as we increase in the food web, right? So I gave each student had sticky notes, and their task was to label each sticky note as a species or an organism. So the only thing was the base had to be the sun, right? Because that's where we get all our energy from. So each sticky note would say sun at the bottom, and they would stick it on the cup, for example, and it would go through. Then I told them to get creative. So I asked them, listen, make a food web, whatever you want. So I said, maybe if you want to be in Africa, if you want to be in the jungle, if you want to be in an aquatic system. And I told them to label and put names of certain species on these sticky notes and put them on the cups. So for example, some students put maybe trees on the first cup, so they wrote tree. And then they wrote, say, grass on the next one. And so on and so forth until we got all the way to the top, where they might put, for example, a shark, right? Or a lion, depending on the ecosystem that they're in. And then I started to ask them about certain relationships. So I asked them, what happens if I were to remove one of these cups? How would it affect the rest of the ecosystem? So what if I'm, for example, a farmer, and I decide that I want to remove this cup right here? How is that going to affect the rest of the ecosystem? If I cut my grass, is that going to leave more food, less food? Is there going to be more energy in the food ecosystem or less energy? So it's just a great way for them to see. So actually what I did was I took the cup and I said, what if I do this? And clearly, as we see, the whole ecosystem kind of falls apart. And that's a good example of how sometimes it takes time to readjust, right? So we have to rebuild our little ecosystem that we have here, and then adjust according to what happened, right? So now we can see that the food chain is significantly smaller than it was before, because now we've lost source of energy. Just a great way for them to go and think about certain relationships in a more fun and practical way. So actually, we did do this in class. It was a great success. They loved it. And I'll show some clips of what I did right now.
But we're gonna do food webs. Everyone knows what a food web is?
Yeah, I know. Yes.
What's a food web?
It's like a group of food chains.
Right, exactly. So we're kind of gonna do that together. So you're kind of already in groups. So in your lab bench, maybe one person from each lab bench can come and pick up a cup. So what do we have in a food chain? We have what? Producers and consumers, okay? Producers, where do they get their energy from? From the sun, right? And how do they get their energy? Photosynthesis, right? Okay, so we're gonna build our pyramids. You guys know how to build a pyramid, or do you need an example? Okay, so our base is gonna be the sun, right? And then what comes after the sun? Producers, and then? Consumer. Yeah, so let's do it. So, but I want you after the sun to start naming different types of species or different types of things. So you would put, for example, grass as the producer. And then you would put what, for example?
A rabbit.
Okay. Yeah, so get creative, have fun. Let's do it. So on your sticky notes, write down what it is. So if it's the sun, you're gonna write the sun and stick it on the cups. Does that make sense? I'll come around.
So let's talk about materials. So all we need is really two things. You're gonna need a pen and pencil, which students will already have. Sticky notes. You don't even have to use sticky notes. You can actually just write them on the cup, depending on the type of cup that you got. I just thought sticky notes was easier if you wanted to move around and think of different interactions. And all you're gonna need is cups. Any disposable cup, plastic cups, recycled cups, anything that's ecologically friendly. And it's very easy to do, very simple. However, we do have to keep in mind class management. How do we get students to focus on what was going on? For me, I found that was a little bit of a struggle. Some students were just playing around. Some people wanted to build huge pyramids. And you can expand this, right? You can build one big, big one with maybe multiple, like a 3D pyramid. and have students think of interactions that way and ecosystems that way. It's really fun, really flexible, very fast, doesn't need much time for cleanup either. Just an overall great experience for the students.